In this video, we will cover the run screen operation and diagnostics when using a configuration with DirectCommand L2 and RightSpot on an InCommand 1200 display. Knowing the location of these tools and settings will allow you to efficiently adjust your sprayer and quickly identify and troubleshoot any issues in the field. We will begin with a RightSpot configuration loaded to the run screen. Before we can begin operation, we need to have a sprayer nozzle active. Tap the green check. To select a nozzle to be active, in the bottom right, tap the settings wrench. Tap the nozzle selection button. Here, we can select from preloaded list of generic ISO nozzles or create a new nozzle. If a custom nozzle has been created, the default view when entering this screen will only show the custom created nozzles. To view the list of generic nozzles, tap the generic checkbox. For this example, we'll tap the TT11005 nozzle that we have previously created and tap the green check. The next setting is product density. For accurate rate control, the display needs to know the density of the product being applied. If density is unknown, it can be calculated by measuring the weight and volume of the sample and typed in below. Tap the back arrow. If your sprayer has a PWM rate control valve, you can adjust control valve settings using the PWM valve tuning utility. If the flow meter needs calibrated or the calibration needs adjusted, that can be done under the flow meter calibration. Tap the back arrow to return to the run screen. In the upper left, tap the legend tab. Here, we can swipe left and right to switch between coverage, rate, and pressure. Next, we'll need to enter a target rate. Tap the rate tab in the upper right to pull it out. Tap the wrench on the rate tab. Here, we can enter values for rate 1, rate 2, and an increment to adjust those on the run screen. Prescriptions can be loaded by tapping the folder icon. Tap the containers tab at the top. Here, we can fill the tank to the capacity defined in the configuration setup, specify the volume in the tank, or empty the tank. The alarm threshold can be adjusted by tapping the bell icon. On the right, you can select it to alarm based on percentage remaining, volume remaining, or turn off the low container alarm. Tap the green check to return to the container settings, and then tap the back arrow to return to the run screen. Now, we can switch between target rate 1 and target rate 2. Tap the RightSpot tab. Here, we can toggle between our two pressure presets as well as activate and shift rate groups. To adjust the pressure presets and define the rate shift groups, tap the wrench. On the left is where the two pressure presets can be adjusted by tapping the plus and minus buttons, or tapping in the middle will pull up the keypad to enter a pressure. Rate shift groups can be used to increase or decrease the duty cycle by a percentage on a selected nozzle or nozzles. This is commonly used along field boundary edges to address increased pest pressure and behind rear tires to overcome dusty conditions. To define the groups, tap the wrench. On the bottom, tap the group you'd like to define. Then, tap the nozzles you'd like to add to the group. Next, enter the percentage you'd like to shift the duty cycle of the selected nozzles. Repeat for remaining groups if desired. It is not required to define all groups. Tap the green check and tap the green check again to return to the run screen. For more information on how the rate shift feature works, please see Rate Shift with RightSpot on the Ag Leader Knowledgebase. Now, we can begin spraying. With sprayers using PWM as the rate control valve, tapping the prime button will turn the pump on and adjust to either the user entered standby pressure or standby duty cycle. That setting can be changed in the configuration setup. In the bottom left, we can see the nozzle is active. The droplet size being applied based on the current pressure reading is also displayed. In the bar graph on the bottom, the duty cycle of each nozzle valve will be displayed. Knowing the duty cycle of each valve can help identify issues as you progress through the field. Since we are on the edge of the field, we'll tap the rate shift group we defined for the outer nozzle to address the increased pest pressure on the outside row. When this rate shift group is active, it is going to increase the duty cycle of the selected nozzle valves as shown in the duty cycle bar graph on the bottom, and on the map, we see the higher rate being applied on that nozzle. To view the diagnostics for DirectCommand L2 and RightSpot, tap the display icon in the upper right, then tap Diagnostics. Tap the DirectCommand L2 module. On the right side, we can see the firmware, serial number, and part number of the module. Tap Diagnostics in the bottom right to open the diagnostics for that module. Here, we can view all the sensor readings, power readings, and valve statuses for the L2 module. Tap the back arrow. Tap the RightSpot hub nozzle controller. On the right, we can view the firmware of the module. Tap Diagnostics. Here, we can view the diagnostics for the RightSpot hub. Tapping the Valve Control Modules tab at the top will show the connected Valve Control Modules, or VCMs. It will also indicate the number of nozzle valves detected by each VCM with the green dot. Gray dots indicate that a valve wasn't detected, and red dots indicate a nozzle valve fault. Tap the back arrow to return to the device list, and tap the back arrow again to return to the map screen. Now, you will be able to efficiently locate and use the tools, settings, and diagnostics on the map screen using a DirectCommand L2 and RightSpot configuration on an InCommand 1200 display. If you'd like to learn more on DirectCommand L2 and RightSpot, please reference the InCommand feature user guide for DirectCommand L2 and RightSpot. If you'd like to see more short tutorials from Ag Leader, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.